We want to find the slope of the line passing through the given points, then determine if the line would be increasing, decreasing, horizontal, or vertical. Given two points on a line, the slope is equal to the change in y divided by the change of x. Looking at the first pair of points, let's let the first coordinates be x sub 1, comma y sub 1, and the second coordinates be x sub 2, comma y sub 2. Therefore, the slope of the line is equal to the change of y is equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1, which should be negative 7 minus 3, divided by the change of x, which would be x sub 2 minus x sub 1, or 4 minus negative 2. Notice we'd have negative 10, our denominator becomes 4 plus 2, which is 6, common factor of 2, so this slope simplifies. Our slope is negative 5/3. Because the slope is negative, we say the line is decreasing. To better understand this, let's look at this line on the coordinate plane. Here are the two given points. We say the line is decreasing because notice as x increases, the y values or function values decrease. Or as we move left and right on the line is going downhill, therefore the line is decreasing and we have a negative slope. Looking at the next pair of points, let's call these the ones, and we'll call these the twos. So again, the slope is equal to the change of y divided by the change of x, or in this case, negative 3 minus 6 divided by 2 minus 2. Well, this would give us negative 9 divided by 0. Well, division by 0 is undefined. And therefore, we have a vertical line. But for our homework system, we're going to type in dne for the slope. And again, because of this, we have a vertical line. Let's take a look at this on the coordinate plane as well. Here are the two given points. It's very easy to see now that we do have a vertical line because the x coordinates are the same and the y coordinates are different. Every vertical line has no slope or an undefined slope, and that's because the slope is equal to the change of y divided by the change of x, and the change of x for a vertical line is 0. So next we have negative 4, comma negative 2, and 6, comma 3. So the slope m is equal to 3 minus negative 2 divided by 6 minus negative 4. So the numerator becomes 3 plus 2, that's 5. The denominator becomes 6 plus 4, that's 10. This simplifies, there's a common factor of 5. The slope is equal to 1/2. And because the slope is positive, we say that the line is increasing. If we look at this line, we say it's increasing because notice as x increases, the y values also increase. Or as we move from left to right along the function, notice how we'd be going uphill. Therefore, we have a positive slope and the line is increasing. Now for our last example, we have negative 3 comma negative 3, and we have 1 comma negative 3. So the slope is going to be equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1, that's negative 3 minus negative 3, divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1, that's 1 minus negative 3. So here we have negative 3 plus 3, that's 0, divided by 1 plus 3, that's 4. Well, 0 divided by 4 would be 0. So the slope is 0, which means we have a horizontal line, or the line is constant. If we take a look at this on the coordinate plane, here are the two given points. Notice in this case, the y coordinates are the same, which is always true when we have a horizontal line. Notice as x increases, there's no change in y, and therefore the change of y is 0, regardless of the change of x, giving us a 0 slope and a horizontal line. I hope you found these four examples helpful.